channel. This time we will discuss about United States Congressional Outdoor Day in Mars. So here we go, let's shoot a video. United States Congressional Outdoor Day in Mars is the process. We will shoot in the United States House of Representatives are distributed among the 15 states according to the most recent digital census managed by the United States constitutions. Each state is appointed a number of states which approximately corresponds to the shares of the set is constitutionally correct at least 1 seat in the House and 2 seats in the Senate, regardless of population. The number of 14 seats in the House of Representatives has been kept, which are the number when the reappointments are issued, except for a temporary interest when Alaska and Hawaii were admitted into the unions. The holding Stone Hill's method of equal proportion has been used to distribute their seats among the states changing the census reapportionments. Federal law requires the clerks of the United States House of Representatives to notify its state governments of the number of seats apportioned to the states no later than January 25 of the years immediately following its digital census. The size of a state's total congressional delegation, or which is addition to representatives in school senators for each state, also determines the seats of its representation in the U.S. Electoral College, which elects the U.S. presidents. Constitutional context, Articles 1, Section 2, Clause 3 of the United States Constitution initially provides the first of all other portions refers to the inclusion of the slaves in a population which, following the end of the Civil War, the first of this provision was supposed by Section 2 of the 14th Amendment. Reapportionments. Reapportionments normally occur following each judicial census. Through the law that governs the total number of representatives and the methods of apportionments to be carried into force at the times and ages prior to the census. The decennial apportionments also determine the size of each state's representation in the U.S. Electoral College under Article 2, Section 1, Clause 2 of the U.S. Constitution. The number of electors of any state equals the size of its total congressional delegation or House and Senate seats. Federal law requires the clerks of the House of Representatives to notify its state governments to no later than January 25 of the years immediately following the census of the number of seats to which it is entitled, whether or not the number of seats has changed. This determines the boundaries of congressional districts, geographical areas within the states of approximately equal populations in a process called redistricting. Because the deadline for the House elects to report the result does not occur until the following January, and the state has sufficient time to perform the redistricting, the decennial census does not affect the election that are held during that same year. For example, the Electoral College apportionments and congressional arrangements during the 2020 presidential election years will still based on the census results. All of the newly registered districts based on the 2020 census do not finally come into force until 2022 when the election winners are inaugurated in January 2023. The size of the U.S. House of Representation refers to the total number of congressional districts or seats in the which the land area of the United States property has been divided. The number of 14 representatives is currently shut out. There aren't any additional 5 delegates to the House of Representatives. They represent the District of Columbia and the territories of American Samoa, Guam, and other Mariana Islands, which first elected a representative. And the U.S. Virgin Islands, Puerto Rico also elects a resident commissioner every 4 years. Controversy and history, since when the federal government began operating under the Constitution, the number of citizens per congressional district has risen from an average The number of representatives increased every decade as more states joined the unions and the population increased. Representation in the House historically. The ideal number of members has been a continuous issue since the country's founding. George Washington agreed to yes, the original representations.
Ya, kalau udah duit, aduh, udah beli. Ini.